you look at the Clinton Foundation?
I'm not going to comment on the existence or non-existence of any other investigations.
Was the Clinton Foundation tied into this investigation?
Yeah, I'm not going to answer that.
That clip you saw was about a month ago. That was Comey pretty much telling the world that, yes, the FBI is investigating the Clinton Foundation because it's probably the biggest slush fund that ever hit American history. It's the biggest criminal organization America has ever saw, so of course they have to investigate. Now, whether they prosecute, that's a whole different story. But there are some things happening before we go into the weekend that I would like to share with you that mainstream media just happens to be ignoring. A complete news blackout. Could you imagine if the FBI brought up a big truck to the Donald Trump campaign headquarters and just started taking all his stuff out of there? The FBI with a search warrant. Could you imagine what mainstream media would be doing if what you were seeing here, what you're seeing with your own eyes, if this was the Donald Trump campaign headquarters? I swear to God, the mainstream media would be all over it. It would be like a circus. It would be like the O.J. Simpson circus. But apparently, because it's Hillary Clinton, there is a mainstream media news blackout. And when I use the word news, yes, I'm using that word extremely loosely. But here we are. A man is dead, and mainstream media practically ignoring it. They don't even put the puzzle together that the DNC staffer is dead. He stabbed Hillary Clinton in the back, and now he's dead. And now here in Philadelphia, you're watching the FBI raid Hillary Clinton's campaign headquarters in Philadelphia. We're watching it with our own eyes. I've seen none of this on mainstream media. Now, I know none of this shocks me, and none of it should shock you either. What mainstream media has turned into is nothing less than Soviet Union propaganda. Yes, we remember back in the 1980s how strong the Soviet Union propaganda army was, and it has now come to America as Hillary Clinton's headquarters are being raided, and that's not news for mainstream media, but I guarantee you if that was Donald Trump's headquarters, it would be a damn mainstream media circus over there. And now we know that Julian Assange has came out and told us that that 27-year-old DNC staffer, Seth Rich, yeah, he was the source. He's the one that stabbed Hillary Clinton in the back. He's the one that stabbed Wasserman Schultz in the back because he knew what they were two evil witches, and they were conniving together to steal the election away from Bernie Sanders. Is the FBI investigating Wasserman Schultz? See, that's where it comes down to. There are two levels in America. There are all us on the bottom, and then there are these dual citizens at the top. And this is what really makes me mad. There's nothing in the world that makes me more mad. When I live in a country where we have foreigners, dual citizens, and I don't care if they were born in America. No, their allegiance is to a foreign power. They tell me all the time, America's nothing. We're dual citizens. We rule the world. We're on all the executive branches of the Department of Defense and Department of Justice. Nothing makes me more sick. Nothing makes me want to throw up more when these dual citizens are above the law, like Debbie Wasserman Schultz. Why is she above the law just because she's a dual citizen? No, it's wrong. The FBI should be all over Debbie Wasserman Schultz. Now, here they are raiding Hillary Clinton's campaign headquarters. Now, whether anything comes of this, I mean, look at the track record, people. Look at the track record. They have been investigating the Clintons for over 30 years and nobody's laid a glove on them. I'm thinking this is all a photo op. I have to say, I'm not going to hold my breath that the FBI are going to put the handcuffs on Clinton. I'm way beyond that. I'm way beyond that the FBI is going to put Clinton in jail. It's not going to happen. I'm not stupid. I mean, for 30 years, these people have been breaking the law. And never have they had to pay for the crimes. So I have to think that this is a photo op. And yeah, and maybe that's why mainstream media is ignoring it, because they know it's just a fake photo op. But that's neither here nor there. I tell you, if this was the Donald Trump campaign headquarters, there would be a circus there. And that's another thing that should make Americans extremely mad. It's this thing where the mainstream media, they let Hillary Clinton lie to America, and they don't say anything about it. They let her get away with it. Mainstream media lets Hillary Clinton lie to us daily. And then, like a 1-2 punch, this is literally a mainstream media 1-2 punch in the face of all Americans. They pretend that Hillary Clinton's lies are the gospel, while at the same time, at the very same time they force-feed us Hillary Clinton's lies, they attack Donald Trump on every single thing he says. If he says that there's people coming across the border doing something bad, oh, the outrage. No matter what Donald Trump says, and it's mostly always the truth. Now, lately, he has said that Hillary Clinton and Obama are the founders of ISIS. That Obama and Hillary created ISIS. How dare the Donald Trump tell the Americans the truth? The mainstream media is outraged. This is really getting on my nerve. And then another, does mainstream media talk about Hillary Clinton's health? I mean, here she is having a seizure right in front of our faces. But they say, no, Hillary's fine. Her doctor, a year ago, her personal doctor, her personal general doctor said a year ago, she's fine, all's good. But yet, what was it? 8-9 years ago, mainstream media wanted John McCain. They wanted his whole health story laid out in front of him. John McCain had to do some real digging into his health records, and he had to hand it over to mainstream media. They demanded it. Mainstream media demanded it because they were for Obama. This is a sham. The American people are waking up to this sham, this mainstream media who's force-feeding us Hillary Clinton's lies. While she's having seizures, she can barely walk up steps. Her Clinton Foundation is $100 million slush fund. It's under investigation by the FBI as we speak, but there's a mainstream media blackout, and at the same time, they attack Donald Trump just because he says Obama created ISIS, which everybody seems to think is the truth. We got CIA officials. We got military officials. We practically got anybody and everybody saying, yes, America created ISIS. How dare Donald Trump tell Americans the truth? And that's what it's come down to. We've got a bunch of prostitutes, a mainstream media that's bought and paid for by some foreign power, and whatever Donald Trump says, they attack him. But I'm here to tell you it's backfiring. I really do. I think that the more that mainstream media does this, the more they make a jackass out of themselves. See, Americans, we ain't as dumb as we look. No. We ain't that dumb. We know when we're being force-fed lies, and yet mainstream media continues to do it. But you know what? I got some extremely good news. Because of what mainstream media is doing, and what are they doing? I'll tell you what they're doing. They're digging themselves a bigger and a bigger hole, and then we're going to push them in the hole. You see, it's already happening. As mainstream media is silent on the truth, as they keep the real news hidden, and then they tell us lies, as they do this, they're digging themselves a huge hole. By backing a criminal like Hillary, they're losing what little respect we ever had for them. By them remaining silent on chemtrails, and the police state, and the military-industrial complex, as the mainstream media does this, and they've been doing it for a while, I tell you, they are dying. That is a good news. That is the extremely good news I'm here to share with you today, that Fox News is losing half their viewers. CNN is losing more viewers. They are almost dead. They're digging a hole, and us Americans, we're going to push them in the hole very soon.